Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you about video number 2 in the fasting and praying series. If you missed last week, I will put the video link down in the description box. It was, will fasting and prayer help you to shrink fibroids naturally? I'll put it in the description box and up in the information bar above. But today I want to talk to you about 3 of my favorite benefits of fasting and praying. And the first one is getting my focus off of my problems and onto God instead. So for example, when I am fasting, I need to focus on God in order to make it through the day, because the type of fasting that I'm doing is I'm denying myself of food. And when I deny myself of food, I have to lean on God in order to make it through the day. So I'm not thinking about what my reproductive health situation is when I'm trying to make it without food. I'm asking God to help me through the day. So my focus is more on Him and less about what my reproductive issue is at the moment. So number 2, after the fast is over, one of the main benefits is that I've actually experienced some relief in my body. Fasting causes the toxins to move out of your body. So oftentimes after fasting, you'll have more energy, your brain will be clear, your body will feel looser. Like, there are tons of benefits from fasting. And last but not least, the things that I have laid before the Lord that I want answers to, He gives wisdom and insight as to what I'm supposed to do with those things. So let me recap. Fasting gets the focus off of me and onto God. I will actually experience some relief after the fast. And lastly, I will gain some wisdom and insight for the things that I've laid before Him. One of the things that I like to do while fasting is read books on fasting so that it provides some type of motivation for me. And one of my favorite books is this book right here. It might be backwards in the frame, but it's called Fast Your Way to Health. So not only is this talking about fasting and praying, because it is, this book is about, it talks a ton about fasting and praying, but it also talks about a healthy lifestyle. This is one of the books that I read when I first started fasting and praying. Early in probably 2006, 2007, I started reading this book. But as you can see, I've got, it's dog-eared, I got sticky notes. I've read this book several times over. As a matter of fact, when I did my 40-day fast, I was actually reading this book. So when I wasn't praying, I would, and I had extra time, and I did, because I was not eating all that food and preparing all that food. Although when I did my 40-day fast, I did prepare dinner for my family. So that is something I would do, but I wouldn't sit there while they were eating. I didn't have that much strength, so I probably could have done it. God probably would have provided that for me. But when I had time other than the times that I was praying, this is the book that I read. And I'll put a link in the description box for this exact book, because the cover doesn't look like this anymore. It's changed. I don't know if it's been updated or not, but this is a really good book if you're looking for a book on not only spiritual fasting, but physical fasting from a Christian perspective. And lastly, if you haven't already signed up, please click the link below to sign up for the Fasting and Prayer Challenge. And you will be receiving an email soon with the instructions. I'm trying to pull it all together, but it will happen soon. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.